Hey friends, this is Emily Hansen from the Austin Nature and Science Center.
Join Miss Emily for her school year series, Fun with Physics. For this series, we're going to learn about simple machines, starting with levers. Let's begin by learning some basic vocabulary: machine, work, and force. What is a machine?
A machine is any device that uses work to move an object from one place to another.
What does work mean in physics?
Work is the force applied to an object that causes it to move.
What does force mean in physics?
Force is the push or pull that you apply to any object that causes it to interact with another object.
Oh, now I get it. So which simple machine are we starting with first again?
The first one is a lever. And the lever basically consists of a beam and a fulcrum, or a balance point. Some good examples of levers are seesaws and fingernail clippers. The simplest example of a lever is a seesaw. The bottom part is called the fulcrum, and the success of the lever depends on how the weight is balanced on either side of the fulcrum. What happens on a seesaw if the weight on either side of the fulcrum becomes unbalanced? Did you know we also have levers in our body? There's a joint between our skull and the two top vertebrae in our spine called the axis and the atlas. That joint acts as the fulcrum. Your head is the load or the weight, and your neck muscles do the work of lifting and pulling your head back and forth and back and forth. Right, so turns out your bent arm is also a lever. The fulcrum is your elbow, your forearm acts as the arm of the lever, and your biceps muscle provides the force needed to lift that weight. If you've ever had to pick up and carry something heavy, you know it takes a lot of work. You might have wanted something to make that work easier. The wheelbarrow acts as both a lever and a wheel. The wheel itself is the fulcrum. The load sits in the bucket, and you do the work by applying force as you lift up from the handles. In order to move the load, you push it forwards and the wheel turns around the axle. Rolling something heavy, like a teenager, is a lot easier than pushing it and carrying it. We're going to demonstrate how a lever works by using a marker or a pencil, a ruler, and a small object like your cell phone, a can of veggies, or in my case, a coffee mug. You want to place the marker underneath the ruler on a flat surface. Try and center the ruler right over the marker. In this case, the marker acts as the fulcrum where the weight is balanced on either side. Now you want to set your object on one side of the ruler. And on the opposite side, you want to press down to try to lift it up off the table. If that doesn't work, you want to move the fulcrum a little bit closer to the object and try it again. You want to keep repeating this until you can move the fulcrum close enough that when you press on the opposite side, you are able to completely lift that object all the way off the table. Oh dear.
Well, I hope you enjoyed learning about some of the simple machines that make our work in this wonderful world a little bit easier. Take some time this week, look around, try to find the machines that make your life easier on a daily basis. I'll see you next week. Bye.